Technique number three, I'm gonna keep the same colors so I don't waste any paint. I know it's kind of boring over here, but whatever. You're still learning, even if it's different colors or same colors. I'm gonna get the other cup, salt. This is some students' other like favorite technique. And when you mix these two together, it looks pretty cool. Since I have this damp and it still hasn't soaked into the paper, I'm just gonna take a little bit of salt and kind of like pinch it on there. And I don't know if you can tell on the camera, but the rubbing alcohol repels the pigment away. And the salt, it like rushes to it and it wants to collect around each little granule of salt. And then when it dries, next time you come in, you pick them all off and they leave these little holes, little pock marks all over the surface where the salt used to be. It takes the pigment away from it. So it looks really cool. So I'm gonna get some color. Again, it's 3 o'clock. You just don't know it because it's probably not 3 o'clock wherever you are right now. So I'm gonna get some color. Put it on here, same thing. You wanna get a lot of pigment on there so it's like pooling. Get the pigment. I have like straight up little chunk of paint on here, perfect. I'm gonna put that over there like that. Get my salt and kind of like spritz it on there. You just, little salt, little season, okay? She's salty, it's salty, okay? So that is how you do that. And then I can add a little more color over here. Maybe allow those to kind of be next to each other. So again, this doesn't really work with yellow. It will, you can get some orange in there or some red and try it, but I want you to do one square with salt now.